Cool kids. I'm gonna tell you what, John, that is gonna look badass.
Oh, it's awesome.
Someone's gonna say, hey, what do you got in the back? What do you got on the hood? I'm gonna say, hey, I got an Edelbrock.
That's right.
And they're gonna say, man, what made you get that? And I go,
hell, I don't know.
Because my buddy told me to get the Edelbrock because that's the best one around.
Yeah,
because he said the Quadrajet is you, if you're gonna have the Quadrajet, you just gotta take a hammer with you whenever you need it.
Yeah, yeah. Right now, we're on deconstruction right now, taking the old Quadrajet off. That's what we're doing, right, Rob?
Well, John, yes, it is. And, you know, as your assistant, I play a cop in real life, and I like to play a mechanic on TV.
Well, you're a good Vanna White.
And so far, I don't think anybody's going to hire me for a TV actor, so I'm just going to sit here. I'm going to be the light guy.
You're the light guy.
I'm
going
to make it look good.
You know, I'm going to speak out to my older kids. My older kids, they were always my light guys, and they were excellent at it. I trained them well. Anthony and Brett, you know what I'm talking about.
Absolutely.
I can't emphasize how important the light position is. It is super important.
Are you trying to tell me something right now?
I'm telling you that, you know.
I got it right there. I'm
on top. Critical to the operation of this whole thing.
I'm not going to let you down, John.
All right, man.
I've known you for 30 years.
I know. You know, you've always been there.
Well, you know that story. Do you ever tell people that story when I rode with you the first time? And we were parked on the side of the road, and it's about midnight, and this guy comes right down at the intersection, squeals his tires, and we are trying to get in high speed pursuit, and the car won't start.
Yes.
It was dead.
That was an old Crown or LTD.
It was a Ford LTD, and we had to call for help just to get the car started again.
You forgot the most funny part. Was I had to grab you. You were riding shotgun. I had to grab you from jumping out and chasing the car on foot. I mean, and that's how you've always been.
I only tried to chase him for about 20 feet, but he was going fast.
That's how you've always been, and you haven't slowed down since. So, yeah, crazy stuff. All right. We've extracted the four-barrel quadrajet carburetor. Now we're going to prime it up for the new Edelbrock.
You see how clean that looks in there, John?
It's a beautiful intake.
I did not clean it or anything, but it looks really cool.
Well, somebody put a new intake on this thing.
Oh, what's this? Is this supposed to be just laying around?
That's part of the filter system.
All right.
Okay. That's looking pretty good, man.
Wow. You know, when this was first bought in 1979, right off the showroom floor from my wife's grandfather, he was so upset because it wasn't a 350, and they said, hey, it's 1979, this is as good as you get. And it was a shiny blue, and hopefully we'll restore it back to the original color. But, you know, has less than 70,000 miles on it, rides like a champ, the interior is incredible. Just a fun-loving car.
It's in excellent shape for this year. Yeah, for sure. Okay. So we got the old quadrajet out. Here it is. These work good, but when they don't work, they really suck and don't work at all. So what we're going to do is replace that with a brand new 600 CFM Edelbrock carburetor, 1406, electric choke. So that's what we're going to put on the old girl, and she's going to like it. She's going to be really happy. So that's what we're going to do now. You ready, Rob?
I'm ready.
All right. See where we're at first off. We may have to get some bolts because the ones that came off of this,
we're off a little bit.
Off of this, were like these really super long ones, right? That isn't going to work, pal.
Well, do you reverse them the other way around?
No, we're going to have to get some shorter bolts like these ones, right? About this size. So we may have to do that unless I got some in my toolbox, which I might. Okay. So that's what we're going to do. I'm just kind of looking at it to see what we're going to have to change, if anything. First thing I notice is those bolts, we're going to have to get some bolts. So two bolts in the front, you're going to have to be different. Okay? No big deal. Everything else looks like it's going to be okay.
This one's supposed to go like, no, yeah, I think it's off, is it?
It just goes like that. It'll go right together.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, you're the boss.
We're good. That's what she's going to do, right?
That's
there.
What it looks like. Mm-hmm. It looks pretty damn cool right there.
It does. It's almost a shame to put an air cleaner on there and cover it up.
Well, if we could fast forward about an hour on this show, we'd probably have it done.
Hour. The longest thing is going to be finding bolts for the front, two bolts, probably. Once we get going on, it'll just take a minute or two, Rob. All right. So we got to search for some bolts. That's what we're going to do right now. Catch you in a minute or two. Get over the top of that, which is fine. Before you rip it all up, let's just see how this one looks like.
You got it.
We are test fitting gaskets. See what the heck can be done. This monstrosity. Let's see. Okay.
It goes right there. There's if you move it right.
The problem I'm having is right here.
We're
going to have to cover that because you'll have a huge vacuum problem there if you don't.
And we don't want that, John.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're going to tighten that bolt down?
Yeah. All right. Bang, bang. See how it covers up that nicely?
Yep. Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't have to put no goop or nothing on it.
You don't?
No.
How come?
Because you don't want to put goop on there It'll make a hell of a mess, and you really don't need it with the gasket, and you'll be fine.
All right.
Keep talking.
Get her close.
All right. What are we looking like on that side, Rob?
Well, it looks pretty good, and you found those bolts. It's a really exciting time.
Yeah.
Well, anytime you can find bolts that fit.
I know.
You know.
What are you talking about being unlucky? That was pretty damn lucky.
I knew my career as a mechanic was over. My brother and I had a 1971 Ford Torino.
Yeah.
With a slant six in it. And it had a tendency to leak oil, so we decided to tighten the head bolts on it. Oh. And we kind of muscled it, and we broke like three of them.
So, and go on, what happened? Let me put this on first.
Well, the car lasted a while until my brother wrecked it. Oh. That's what happens when you have to share a car with your brother. You know, somebody's going to wreck it, and it wasn't me.
I guess one good thing with you guys, you could use the same driver's license. Okay, let me double check this real quick. Okay.
All right,
this has got to fit into there.
Okay. So we need that.
But it may not. If it's the wrong size, we're kind of SOL and all those things.
It wants to go, but I think it is.
I think it's too big.
So how do you?
Fitting off of the old carburetor and putting it on the new carburetor, and then that hose will fit because it goes to this fitting. So this goes on here like that. Now the line isn't going to know that this is a new carburetor. It's going to think it's the same old quadrajet because it's got the right fitting on it, right? Think about it as you don't want to over tighten this because it's like you were having your story there.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're going to get it good. German specs, good and tight. You know?
Okay.
Rob's trying to do the disco thing.
Well, I was trying to do it. I wonder if you concentrate better when we do it that way.
I don't know, man.
Well, I was trying to get back to the 70s. You know, we're in the 70s, you know, and they had strobe lights and stuff. Now, John, I know you're a singer in a band, an 80s rock band, and you guys rock. But did you ever sing the Bee Gees?
Dude, I gotta tell you, before I was into rock and roll,
staying alive. I mean, did you have the shoes and the bell bottoms like John Travolta?
No.
Or were you too busy having kids by then?
No, I was young, man. I was. But then it all changed for me. I was the Bee Gees, Elton John, all that stuff. Then it changed for me. It was the first time my buddy Art Hedman comes over to my house. And what's he got in his hand? But the new Van Halen.
Oh my gosh.
And is that awesome? After I heard that, it was over.
Yeah.
I was a rocker the rest of my life. So, this is just being a
This is being mean, John.
To being a bugger.
Mean-spirited is what I think.
The thing about it is I don't want to cross the right edge.
All right. So we got to do the...
Get the gasket kind of in the back.
Okay. You got it right back to me?
It's close.
You dialed in, buddy.
Yeah. Hey, now we should put some bolts in. But, wait, now we gotta get this side down there. Goes like that. Right?
Right.
That helps with the linkage to the whole throttle, because you want to be able to switch the gas and have the throttle move. That's important. I don't know what the CFM on that quadrajet was, but it had some pretty big secondaries in it, so it might have made a little bit bigger carburetor than this one. That's okay. This one's gonna be... awesome piece of equipment.
So John, is it the carburetor that is just gives the power to the? Because I don't know anything about carburetors, and everybody says, you want this carburetor, you want that one. And when we were picking this out, you know, this was your choice.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I guess you need to let.
I just need to see why that is not wanting to go in there.
What are you doing, John?
Trying to put this back bolt in.
Let me see if it. Hang on for one sec. It's not lining up is what it's not doing.
Where's the carburetor going to move? Or?
No, it's not even lining up with the...
the gasket's off.
Well, it's not even lining up with the with this. Oh. See what I'm saying? So it's like you.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah. That's okay. We don't really need it. We'll tighten it down over here.
Okay. But you're still gonna have to put that down there, right?
Let's see. How am I gonna do that? I'm trying to think now.
Or do you put it on this one and let that one hang free?
Well, one or the other. Is that the hole where the
threads
are, or am I on the outside?
Wait a minute. Or anything on these.
That's where it was before.
There you go. Perfect.
It'll be all nice and comfy there.
Looks comfy already, John. I feel pretty comfortable.
Yeah. Hey, welcome back, man. We're at my buddy Rob's garage. We're going to finish up a project we started a couple months ago, right, Rob?
Yeah, it's been a while.
We put a carburetor, Edelbrock carburetor on his... what's the year of this car?
This is a 1979 Chevy El Camino. It was... purchased right off the showroom floor in 1979 by my wife's grandfather, and he was upset at the time because it wasn't a 350, but it was the only one showing, and the way it looked back in 1979 was just a beautiful car. And mm-hmm. So he got it, and he's passed on, and he passed it on to us, because every time I go to their house, I always end up waxing it. The only time it ever pulled out of the garage, he quit driving it for years, and I would wax it and just stare at it, and eventually he gave it to me. And
well, it's in
really
excellent
blessed.
Shape, I'll tell you that.
Oh my gosh, it's got some history on it, mm-hmm. but what a great car. And so, we looked at this and we had the carburetor on, and then you were putting that item on from Hot Rod International. I said, Innovations. Yeah. I'm sorry, but I was watching, I go, I want that on my car.
Yeah.
Because, we were talking about, we were having some things with the spring. I just want to do it right. And
sure.
I think with Hot Rod Innovations, with the new item that they have on there, uh-huh. I think the car is going to run. It's running great now, but even better when we get it on
there. Well, that's just an extra piece of coolness on the car, man.
Absolutely.
I think it's a great piece, of work.
It looks so much better, and I'll tell you
how's the Edelbrock working out.
Oh my gosh, after it was put on, we went out driving, and I'll tell you, it's such a difference in power. It's the power's there, there's no hesitation, it's just automatically right there, and mm-hmm. it's just a fun car to drive.
Yeah,
just awesome,
as it should be.
Yes.
So cool, man. We're gonna put the spring on, and probably going to have the helpers, John Steady, the master fabricator, and the Da Vinci of Airbrush is going to be here to help out. So we're going to finish off this project for my buddy Rob on his cool El Camino, man. Stick around. It's coming right at you.
All right, Rob. So I got you that innovation, Hot Rod Innovation this spring. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually take this return spring, which, as you see, when we press on the throttle, it expands, right, instead of retracting. So if you were to ever break the spring, you'd be stuck at wide open throttle. And two ways to stop that: shut the car off and coast to a stop, or wreck. So this was one of the biggest flaws that any manufacturer had. So we'll take this spring and we'll get it out of here and start fresh with a new Hot Rod Innovation spring and totally reverse this situation. There we go. We'll get that out.
Okay.
Rob, so what we got here is the new return spring from Hot Rod Innovation. Remember on this one, when we throttled, we pulled on it. This one, we're actually going to compress. So this is the whole idea, that if this ever breaks, it's self-contained. You'll never lose control of the car. You'll always have control of it.
So Randy, on these, does Hot Rod Innovations just make these for older cars, or are they for newer cars?
They're pretty much for the classic car, for older classic cars, people that restore them. They make them for carbureted motors, for electronic fuel injected motors, which like Holley and Edelbrock, they have a electronic fuel injection system that kind of looks like this, and they make the springs for those too. It's basically for the classic car. It's for the show cars and stuff like that. But to me, you're sitting on 250 horsepower underneath this motor that you don't want to lose control of. It 79 El Camino, you can't replace this,
right?
Especially this car, it's sentimental and everything. You can't replace it, so why have something that can destroy the car? Vacuum cruise control, get some of this stuff off, and we'll start putting the bracket on.
So Randy, with that new the hot rod innovation, what will that give me? Will it give me more power? Because when you put on John's car, I mean, it was talking about the power that it would give you, the more
it's not going to really give you any more power. What it's going to give you is it's going to give you control over your throttle as far as the tension of it. So okay. You'll have either a lighter foot, a lighter acceleration pedal, or stiffer if you like it stiffer, depending on how you like it, you can adjust it. But one of the things that it's going to do is contain the spring inside itself. So instead of pulling on it, you're going to actually compress it, which is a safety device in these vehicles. It's going to keep you from losing control. If that spring was to ever break, you're going to still control over your vehicle.
Wow, that's incredible.
That's the best thing about this thing is the fact that, I mean, there's so many horror stories out there of people losing control of their vehicle after the spring breaks. It goes to wide open throttle and it's either it revs to red line and blows up, or they have to shut it down and just you're stranded. And all because of a stupid 4-cent spring.
Wow.
So then these just look at today's technology. It's billet construction. It's a lot stronger.
Yeah. It's got a clean look to it. You know,
That's one of the, I love the look, but I grew up around hot rods that I've heard the horror stories. I've witnessed them, and it scares the crap out of me is what it does. You gotta love cars. They always have that one tray to put everything into. So we're gonna take this out and get us a nice pretty steel braided one and cut it to size and have an original adjustable one. So I said, now we got our return spring back in. We've got the bracket mounted. We've got, unfortunately, we had to use the stock bracket for the kickdown cable because the kickdown cable is a little short, but we are now going to run our throttle cable nice and neat and put it back on. But basically our return spring looks good.
All right, we just cut the cable to length with the little sleeve. Now we're going to put the adjusting nut over that. Nice, clean setup. Perfect.